A crucial three-game homestand continues tonight in a Central Division showdown. It's the Wild and the first-place Nashville Predators inside the XL Energy Center.
And Parisi controls for the Wild. Ahead for Charlie Coyle. He fires and a save by Rene. First chance for Minnesota tonight came off the stick of red-hot Charlie Coyle. Deflects to the corner. A collision there, and it's chipped past Watson, a two-on-one. Koivu has Coyle with him. Koivu fires, saved by Rene, and the puck loose beneath him. He's able to cover and get a whistle.
I thought the defenseman played this outstanding. Pekka Rinne looked a little bit deep in his net.
PK Subban carries ahead. Forsberg into the Minnesota zone. His shot was deflected wide. Subban nudges it along the boards. Try to get it down low to Forsberg. Back to Subban across, and a sprawling save by Dubnyk. Rebound, they score. Dubnyk stopped the first chance, but he could not stop Johansson on the rebound, and Nashville has the game's first goal.
Everything he possibly can to make the first save, getting a blocker on it. Caught his pad on the post and kind of spun his body around backwards. Unfortunately for Devin and the Minnesota Wild, that loose puck pops right back onto Johansson's stick.
You're just talking about the first two forwards in the zone. Doesn't matter the position. First two guys in on the puck.
First two guys on the puck.
Dubnyk senses trouble here and covers in the blue paint.
This puck was laying loose right between Devin Dubnyk's feet. He had no idea right away that that puck was lying there loose. Fortunately for the Minnesota Wild, they weren't able to bang that in. With the left-handed shot, Fiala taking the shot off the faceoff. They scored a goal here just recently to end a game with about a minute left in the game. So you got to be aware of faceoffs. We got some.
Zucker out to Staal, who's in on the breakaway, looking for 40 and denied by Rene. Sissons had it briefly, but taken away by Foligno. Eriksson Ek got it to Coyle in the corner. Back to Eriksson Ek, moving in, and a kick save by Rene.
On this shot here from Eriksson Ek, he got out on top of his paint and really took the angle away from Eriksson Ek. He can get something cooking here.
Zucker puts on the brakes along the boards. Takes a couple of shoves from Ellis. Prosser moving in, centers! Zucker unable to redirect.
I thought he did it. I originally thought this was a hook, but after watching it a couple times, he does a great job of getting his stick underneath Jason Zucker's stick.
Ekholm leads it ahead. Sissons into the Minnesota zone, a save by Dubnyk, and the loose puck grabbed by Zucker.
This is a huge save, not just once, but twice by Devin Dubnyk to keep this score 1-0.
Knocked away by Murphy. Salamaki had it for a moment, but then Zucker finds Granlin, and the Wild have numbers at the Nashville line. Granlin works around a check, trying to get it back to Staal. Murphy a drive, and a save by Rene.
Erik Staal looking for his 40th, unable to get his 40th there.
Winnick working toward the net, and his redirect goes over the top of the goal. Foligno battling for the puck along the end wall. Winnick to Foligno, off front, Eriksson Ek scores!
No one's getting knocked around the front of the net. The Minnesota Wild were pretty much able to do whatever they wanted in the scoring zone, but in order to take advantage of the Nashville Predators defensively, you've got to get pucks down below the goal line. That is a huge goal to get the Minnesota Wild back into this game.
Trying to work free, hands it off to Koivu. Koivu around Forsberg, drives to the net, saved by Rene. Loose puck controlled by Koivu, still with it down low. Spins it back up high for Staal. Staal, a long shot, saved by Rene. Zucker on the rebound, fanned on it. Got it in the slot, Staal fires, gloves, saved by Rene. Staal was setting up for the one-timer. Zucker goes to Murphy. Murphy's shot right on, saved by Rene. Niederreiter got a whack at it. Zucker fires, Niederreiter scores!
Pekka Rinne unable to squeeze the shot from Mr. Murphy. Probably about an hour and a half from Coor, where Nino Niederreiter live and grew up. So it's outstanding that he could score a goal in front of his Swiss buddies. But more importantly, that's a huge goal for the Minnesota Wild.
Brodin holds and sends it over the top of the goal. Forsberg has it knocked away by Staal. Zucker tries to jam it in, he scores!
That's where a lot of times you get rewarded. Congratulations to Jason Zucker, his 30th goal of the season. He's had an outstanding season, has not gone more than 8 games in a row this year without scoring a goal. He's been a much more consistent player this year than he has been in the past. It's a big reason why he got to 30th. Congratulations to Jason Zucker. These next 5 minutes are very, very important because you're going to get a push right now from the Nashville Predators.
Niederreiter carries in for Minnesota. A shot saved by Rene.
We got the greatest fans in the world, and they play a big, big role in that.
Wild's current home success is on pace to be one of the best in franchise history.
After his 30th goal, going to play keep away against three Nashville Predators down low. You don't think scoring goals makes you feel good, gives you a little bit of confidence?
Stahl in the corner, tried to center. Across for Murphy, winds and fires, saved by Rene. And this time he's able to snatch it out of the air. A very similar play to the time he lost the handle, and Niederreiter took advantage for the go-ahead goal in the second period. Coverage in your own zone, or even just better ways we can attack the next time we're on the ice.
Well, it's very important because even...
Great job, Charlie. Pass one out of the air, and Rene hangs on.
That guy played baseball.
And now Winnick controls across to Koivu. Koivu hits the Nashville line. Fires, and a glove save by Rene. Gives to Johansson. Sets up in the circle, back to Subban, and now Johansson moving in. Across to Forsberg. He went back across the grain, but missed over the top of the goal. Minnesota zone around behind the net. Dumba tried to deflect. Loose puck grabbed by Granlund. Shorthanded rush for the Wild. Granlund has Koivu with him. He fires, and a save by Rene. 23-8 since the end of the first period. Josi with a shot. This one does get through on goal. And Dubnyk tried to smother. Ekholm winds, fires. Skate saved by Dubnyk. Josi got it through to Smith. He fires high and wide. Good support by Koivu to grab the loose puck. Back to Dumba. Winds, fires, and a tip shot goes wide. Ellis. Into the good poke check by Granlund, knocks it away. Parisi after it for Minnesota with Ellis back. His backhander scores! Seventh goal in 11 games for Parisi. The knockout punch delivered by the Wild, and they lead the first place Predators 4-1.
Zach Parisi in a foot race for an empty net. Good luck. Seventh goal in 11 games for Zach Parisi. They continue to play the way they're playing. I got a feeling they're going to get to 100 again. Tremendous accomplishment by Bruce Boudreau.
The total now stands at 92, and the Wild match the wins posted earlier in the day by Central Division rivals Colorado and St. Louis. Minnesota restores their 2-point lead over the Avs, 3-point lead over the Blues, with a game at hand compared to both clubs.
Minnesota Wild had 4 days off, and a lot of times when you have 4 days off, it takes a little bit of time for you to get your legs back. The Minnesota Wild got stronger and stronger as the game went on.